Good morning students, welcome back to maths class. In the last class we completed constructions. Today we will continue with triangles. In triangle chapter, area of similar triangles. So what is the relation between areas and the speciality of the sides of the similar triangles? So here, starting with theorem. So theorem states that area of the ratio of the areas of two triangles will be equal to their square of the ratio of their corresponding sides. That is, there are two triangles ABC and PQR. In this theorem states that ratio of the areas of two similar triangles are equal to the square of the ratio of their corresponding sides. So here we will write given that both the triangles are similar. Triangle ABC similar to triangle PQR. Once the triangles are similar, we know that their corresponding angles are equal and sides are proportional. So I'll write the proportionality of the sides. AB by PQ is equal to BC by QR is equal to AC by PR. And corresponding angles are also equal. We have to prove that ratio of the areas of these two similar triangles, that is area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to square of their corresponding sides. So we will write it as, here we will consider the side BC and QR are the corresponding side. So we will write BC square by QR square. So here, given that both the triangles are similar, if the triangles are similar, angles are equal and the sides are proportional, we wanted to prove that ratio of their areas will be equal to the ratio of the square of their corresponding sides. For this, we have to do a small construction. Construction is, draw a perpendicular AL to BC. Here AL. AL perpendicular to BC and PM perpendicular to QR. PM perpendicular to QR. So this is angle perpendicular. So now we will do the proof. Proof. So in proof, we will consider these two triangles, that is triangle ABL and triangle PQR. So we will write in triangle ABL and triangle PQR. PQR. We'll prove that these two triangles are similar. So here already angle L is equal to angle M. Single letter will write angle L is equal to angle M 90 degree. Reason we will write construction. Next we will write angle B is equal to angle Q. Why angle B is equal to angle Q? Because triangles are similar. So we will write it is given. So two angles are equal. Therefore triangle ABL is similar to triangle PQM by AA criteria. So now we will write the ratio of the corresponding sides. So normally when we write three sides, we will write, here we will write only two sides. If you want, we can write all the three sides, but the important sides are, first one is perpendicular. So AL by PM is equal to, next we will write AB by PQ. AB by PQ we will write. Third one is BL by QR, that we will not write. So this reason is CPST, corresponding parts of the similar triangles. So we will consider these two triangles. Angle L is equal to M by construction. Angle B is equal to Q, that is given because triangles are already similar, ABC and PQR. Triangles are similar by AA criteria, these two triangles. And the ratio of the sides AL by PM is equal to AB by PQ. And we will write it as equation 1. In the given part, we had written that AB by PQ is equal to BC by QR. BC by QR we will write. So here this is equation number 2. So this is given. So from 1 and 2 we can say that here AB by PQ is equal to AL by PM. Again AB by PQ is equal to BC by QR. We can write from 1 and 2 AL by PM is equal to BC by QR. So we proved triangles are similar. We had written the ratio of the sides. Then we had written AB by PQ equals BC by QR from given. From 1 and 2, as one pair of ratios are equal, the other pair are equal. Now, what we have to do is, next part, we will write, therefore, we wanted to find the ratio of the areas. Area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR. PQR is equal to, we know that area is equal to half BH. So, half into area of the first triangle base is BC and the height is AL. By second triangle PQR, base is QR and the height is PL. Now, here half and half will cancel. We will write BC by QR into AL by PM we will write. Now, we have to prove that area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to BC square by QR square, ratio of their corresponding sides. So, here BC by QR we will write as it is into, instead of AL by PM, we will again write BC by QR. BC by QR. Reason we will write AL by PM is equal to BC by QR. Therefore, BC into BC, BC square by QR square. Area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is BC square by QR square. Now, once again, area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to not only the square of the sides BC square by QR square, we can write AB square by PQ square. That will be equal to BC square by QR square. And that is equal to AC square by PR square. So, ratio of the areas will be equal to square of this ratio of their corresponding sides. So, in question sums when we are doing, according to the question, we can take any one corresponding side. But remember, ratio of the areas when we write, we have to write square of the ratio of their sides. So, we proved that area of triangle ABC by area of PQR is equal to square of their corresponding sides. Now we'll move on to exercise. Exercise 2.4. First question. Let triangle ABC similar to triangle DEF and their areas be respectively 64 cm square and 121 cm square. If EF is equal to 15.4 cm, find BC. So the first question, triangle ABC similar to triangle DEF. Triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. DEF. So given we will write triangle ABC similar to triangle DEF. Next it is given that and their areas be 64 cm square and 121. That is area of triangle ABC is 64 cm square and area of triangle DEF is 121 cm square. And EF is equal to 15.4 cm. EF 15.4 cm. We have to find BC. So, as we learn, triangles are similar. Here areas are given. Ratio of the areas will be equal to square of the ratio of the corresponding sides. So BC and EF are corresponding sides. EF is given. We should find BC. So here we will directly write area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DEF is equal to, here as the side EF is given and we want to find BC, we will write BC square by EF square by theorem. So here as it is given that triangles are already similar, we don't want to prove that the triangles are similar. If it is not given, first we have to prove triangles are similar, then we will write the formula. So here area of triangle ABC is 64 and area of triangle DF is 121 is equal to BC square by 15.4 square. So we want to find out BC. So here we know that if BC square is 64, what about BC? BC is square root of 64 and we will get 8. So that according to that we will write, first I will write BC square by 15.4 the whole square is equal to 64 by 121. Once again I am writing. Now we will write BC by 15.4. So when I am writing BC here, right side we have to take the square root. So here both the side we will take the square root. Numerator and denominator will take the square root. Square root of 61 is 8 and square root of 121 is 11. So we will get BC by 15.4 is equal to 8 by 11. BC by 15.4 is equal to 8 by 11. So we will cross multiply. 11 BC is equal to 8 into 15.4. BC equals 8 into 15.4 by 11. So in 11 table we will cancel. 11 ones are 11. Here 11 ones are 11. 4, 44. Point is there. So 1.4. So we will multiply 8 into 1.4. 8 fours are 32. 3, 11.2. So the length of the side BC corresponding to side EF is 11.2 centimeter. Second question. Diagonals of a trapezium ABCD with AB parallel to DC intersect each other at the point O. If AB equals 2CD, find the ratio of the area of triangle AOB and triangle COD. So it is given that ABCD is a trapezium. ABCD is a trapezium where AB parallel to CD or DC and AB equals 2CD. AB equals 2CD. We wanted to prove that, we wanted to find the ratio of area of triangle AOB and triangle COD. That is ratio of area of triangle AOB is to area of triangle COD. So as it is areas, we will apply the formula for area of similar triangles. Before that, these two triangles area ratio we have to find out AOB and COD, but triangles are not similar, it is not given. So first we have to prove that the triangles are similar. Already this type of sum we did in the previous exercise, trapezium questions. So very important question this is. So to find this, first we will consider these two triangles in triangle AOB and triangle COD. We have to prove that these two triangles are similar by any one of the criteria. So we will write angle OAB is equal to angle OCD. You know the reason, it is alternate angle. OAB equals angle OCD, reason AB and CD are two parallel lines and AC is the transversal. Similarly, we can write angle OBA is equal to angle ODC. Angle OBA is equal to angle ODC. This both reason is alternate angle. If you want, you can write one more angle, that is vertically opposite angle. Or only two angles, we can write that these two triangles are similar by AA criteria. Similar by AA criteria. If you want to write one more angle, then you can write triangles are similar by AAA similarity criteria. Now, once the triangles are similar, we will write the ratio of the sides. So, ratio of the sides will start from this triangle. First, we will write OA. So, the corresponding side will be OC. Next, we will write OB. Corresponding side is OD. And the third side, AB. And the corresponding side is DC. Here you will write the reason CPST. So we proved that these two triangles are similar. Now we have to find the ratio of their areas. So now we will write area of triangle AOB by area of triangle COB. According to the theorem, ratio of the areas will be equal to square of the ratio of the corresponding sides. So we can take any one side square ratio we can write, but according to the question, we have to decide which side we have to take. As it is given that AB is equal to 2CD, we will take the last ratio, that is AB by CD. So whenever we will write this formula, we have to write the square of the corresponding sides, AB square by DC square, by theorem we will write, is equal to A, they said AB is equal to 2CD. So instead of AB, we have to write 2CD square, whole square we have to write, by DC, 2DC by DC square. 2DC square, 2 square is 4 and DC square we will write by DC square. DC square will cancel, we will get 4 by 1. Area of triangle AOB by area of triangle COD is equal to 4 by 1. Therefore, area of triangle AOB is 2. We want the ratio. Area of triangle COD is equal to 4 is to 1. Very important question for 2 marker. Now, third question. In the given figure, ABC and DBC are two triangles on the same base BC. If AD intersects BC at O, show that area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DBC is equal to AO by DO. So, two triangles are there on the same base. If AD intersects BC at O, to prove area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DBC equals AO by DO. So given you will write triangle ABC and DBC are two triangles on the same base BC. So ABC and DBC are two triangles on the same base BC. We have to prove that area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DBC is equal to AO by DO. But AO and DO are not the sides of the given triangle ABC or DBC. So here we will do the construction. Construction is draw AO perpendicular to BC. So from the first triangle ABC, we'll draw a perpendicular. So AM, we will draw AM. This is O. AM perpendicular to BC. And for this second triangle BDC, from D we will draw the perpendicular. That we will write it as DL perpendicular to BC. So ABC and DBC are two triangles. So here O is a point, but AO and DO are not the sides of the triangle ABC or DBC. We have to prove that ratio of these two triangles will be equal to AO by DO. For that, we did the construction, draw AM perpendicular to BC, for the base BC, and DL perpendicular to the same base BC. Now, we'll start the proof. So first, we have to prove that these two small triangles are similar, because in proof, we want AO and DO. So we will consider the triangles which includes AO and DO. So these two triangles are similar. First, we have to prove. In triangle AOM and triangle DOL and triangle DOL, we can say that angle M is equal to angle L. Construction, 90° by construction. Then we can write angle AOM is equal to angle DOL, vertically opposite angle. Angle AOM is equal to angle DOL, vertically opposite angle. Therefore, triangle AOM is similar to triangle DOL by AA criteria. So we proved that these two triangles are similar. Once the triangles are similar, we will write the ratio of the sides. First side we will write AM. AM by DL. AM by DL is equal to AO by DO. Is equal to MO by LO or OM by OL. three sides we had written CP, ST. So we proved two triangles are similar by constructing two perpendiculars AM and DL to the base BC and the ratio of their sides we had written. Now we wanted to prove that area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DBC is equal to AO by DO. So we will write area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DBC is equal to, here we will apply area of a triangle formula half BH. So half into base of the first triangle ABC is BC and the height is A, height is the perpendicular. For the second triangle DBC, half into the same base BC and the height is DL. So we will cancel half, half, even BC also. We will get area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DBC is equal to AM by DL. We will get AM by DL. But we want AO by DL. We already proved that AM by DL is equal to AO by DL. So we will substitute instead of AM and DL, AO by DL. Reason we will write AM by DL is equal to AO by DL. So we proved that ratio of their areas are equal to AO by DL. Next question. If the areas of two similar triangles are equal, prove that they are congruent. Areas of two similar triangles are equal, prove that they are congruent. So we will consider two triangles. Areas of two similar triangles. Normally, for similar triangles, area will never be equal. The reason is that their sides will be always proportional. So, areas cannot be equal. If the triangles are congruent only, areas will be equal. AB is equal to DE, BC is equal to EF and AC is equal to DF. All the corresponding angles are equal. Then we can say the triangles are, areas will be equal. So, here, if the areas of two triangles, similar triangles are equal, so it is given that triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF and their areas are also equal. Area of triangle ABC is equal to area of triangle DEF. So, if the areas are equal, then we have to prove that they are congruent. Triangles are congruent. So, to prove triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. So, to prove triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF, we have to say that all the three corresponding sides are equal. Instead of saying corresponding sides are proportional, we have to say corresponding sides are equal because already angles are equal. So, now proof we will start. So, given that area of triangle ABC is equal to area of triangle DEF and triangles are similar. So, we will write area of triangle ABC is equal to area of triangle DEF. This is given. Now, we will divide this to the left side. That is, area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DEF. When you divide area of triangle DEF to the left side, right side it will be 1 we will get. You cross multiply and see area of triangle DF into 1 become area of triangle DF. So this we will write it as equation 1. So it is already given triangles are similar, areas are equal. So once areas are equal, area of ABC by area of DF is equal to 1. And if the triangles are similar, we can apply the area formula. That is area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DF is equal to square of their corresponding sides we have to write. As we want to prove that triangles are congruent, we want all the three sides. So, we will write square of the corresponding, all the three corresponding sides we will write. So, AB by DE square is equal to BC square by EF square is equal to AC square by EF square, DF square. Equation 2 we will write. So, this is by theorem. So, from 1 and 2, see LHS, area of ABC by area of DF, LHS are equal, RHS will be equal. So, we will write from 1 and 2, we can write all these square of the ratios will be equal to 1. We will write AB square by DE square is equal to BC square by EF square is equal to AC square by DS square. This is the RHS of second equation is equal to RHS of the first equation, that is 1. Now what we will do is, we will compare each square ratio to 1. That is, AB square by DE square is equal to 1, right? We will cross multiply. AB square is equal to DE square, we will write. We will take square root on both the side. AB equals DE. Take square root on both the side. Similarly, we will write BC square by EF square is equal to 1. Cross multiply. BC square is equal to EF square. BC is equal to EF. If squares are equal, square root will be equal. Then the third ratio, AC square by DF square is equal to 1. AC square is equal to DF square by cross multiplying. And AC is equal to DF. So we proved that AB is equal to DE, BC is equal to EF, and AC is equal to DF. Therefore, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF by SSS postulate. So we proved that if the area of two similar triangles are equal, the triangles are congruent. Very important question.
Fifth question. D, E and F are respectively the midpoints of the sides AB, BC and CA of triangle ABC. Find the ratio of area of triangle DEF and triangle ABC. D, E and F are the midpoints of the sides AB, BC and AC. So given that D, E and F are the midpoints of the sides AB, BC and AC of triangle ABC, we have to find the ratio of the area of to find the ratio of area of triangle DEF, triangle DEF and triangle ABC, area of triangle ABC. So here now we will join all these three midpoints and we will get the triangle DEF. So we wanted to prove that area of triangle DEF, area of triangle D, sorry, find the ratio of the area of triangle DEF and ABC. So proof we will start. So in 9th standard, we learned that if D and F are the midpoints of any two sides of a triangle, then that line will be joining to the third side and half of the third side. So D and F are the midpoints of AB and AC. Then DF will be parallel to BC and DF will be half of BC by midpoint theorem. So we will apply midpoint theorem here. We will write only DF is equal to half of BC. DF is equal to half of BC by midpoint theorem. Midpoint theorem states that if in D and F, sorry, midpoints of two sides of a triangle, then if we join that, that line will be parallel to the third side of the triangle. So, midpoint theorem. So, here BC we will divide, that is DF by BC is equal to half. We will write it as equation 1. Same way, D and E are the midpoints of the two sides of a triangle AB and BC. We can say that D is half of AC. Half AC, the same midpoint theorem. So, we will write D by AC is equal to half. Equation 2. Same, we'll write. Next, E and F are the midpoints of the two sides AC and BC. We can write EF is equal to half of AB. So EF by AB is equal to half. So now we got three equations by midpoint theorem. When we compare all the three equations from 1, 2 and 3, we will get DF by BC is equal to D by AC is equal to EF by AB is equal to half. All the ratios are equal. Now we want to find the areas ratio. So now we will write area of
triangle DEF by area of triangle ABC. We wanted to find the ratio between these two triangles. So normally when we write the ratio of their areas, we have to write square of their corresponding sides. As all the ratios are equal to half, any one side we can write. So I'll write DF square by BC square, and that is equal to DF by BC. DF square by BC square can be written as DF by BC the whole square. That will be separately DF square by BC square. DF by BC is 1 by 2. So what is 1 by 2 square? It is 1 by 4. Therefore, area of triangle DEF is to area of triangle ABC is equal to 1 is to 4. The ratio is 1 is to 4. That's all for today. Thank you.